morning.
Reason out with their comments.
Joe Wild.
Well, Joe Wild gave me a Bible, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday night.
Anybody else? Oh, I'm thinking about the young man that Dwight went to school with, played ball with and everything. They're having his funeral this afternoon, and a member of the Scott Rickles family.
Sorry, folks, I don't even know how to turn my camera around.
David knows it.
Huh?
David and him were friends. I didn't know, he was telling me about a young man he went to school with died. I didn't know it was Mr. Rickles.
Scott Rickles. Anybody else got anything? Anybody got a prayer request?
Yeah, I remember Carolyn, when she's in really bad shape.
Ryan, would you take us forward and pray and ask for us in the phone office today, please? Number 194 and volume 10. and we want to dedicate this to Sister Carolyn Owens today. And just don't ask her blessing of the Lord upon her life today.
Praise be that I'll do that to God's will in my life.
142.
126.
He's done nothing for me lately.
Discouraged.
Well, we can be encouraged, amen. I remember bringing one time with David. The Bible said David encouraged himself in the Lord, amen, sir. But if you're here this morning, you're down and out, you're discouraged, my advice to you, just encourage yourself in the Lord, amen. I promise you this, but if you look at this world, you'll see discouragement. But if you look to him this morning, I promise you this, you can see encouragement, amen. Anyone else got anything they want to say? Some you want to say, testimony? I wouldn't let Satan rob me this morning.
I got something to say.
Come on.
Satan can work now.
Bless you, Lord.
Get me down. Discouraged, trying to work my faith. Get me in bed. Severe pain. I've been good 5 days in a row. I just want to pray to God. If I get me down this morning.
Bless you.
We're living good.
Bless you.
God bless
you.
God
bless you.
You're here to hear his word. Thank God.
God bless you. God bless you.
God bless you.
Now, you had been in bed for the last 4 or 5 weeks for pain. He has a big praise the Lord this morning. Why can't you? Amen. You know what it comes down to? Bible says we have not because we ask not. So that's what it comes down to. We're treated on this side. Amen. And being satisfied right where we are.
Yep.
So that's the worst condition you can get. Be satisfied right where you are. So you want to be always be trying to move closer to the Lord. Give that to God's got to be. Anyone else? Anyone else to you? Anything you feel like you need to do? Not this morning you pray for us. Have your Bible flip with us for a few minutes. 1 Peter, 5th chapter.
Derek, please moderate. I'm going out.
1 Peter, 5th chapter. I need your prayer this morning, church. I know I'm nothing this morning but myself, and I need a touch from God. I need his help. I need his anointing this morning. So you pray for us. If we do that, God help us today this morning. I'm going to start reading verse number 1. We're going to start with Father. I'm going to back up and start with verse number 1. I've said to the elders which are among you, I exhort, who am also an elder and a witness of the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for a filthy lucre, but of a ready mind. Neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, you shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder. Yea, all of you be subject one to another, and be clothed with humility. For God resisteth the proud, and giveth grace to the humble.
Amen.
Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil as a roaring lion walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
Amen.
Whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, After that you have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Now, I want you to pray for us this morning. And brother, this is a beautiful scripture. This is not just beautiful scripture, but it's a beautiful scripture this morning. Now, I'm going to start back in this sixth verse. Go on with the message. You pray for us that God anoints this morning. The Bible says, and this is very important, listen to this. The Bible says, humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Now, if I had a title for this message or a thought to preach on, really it would be this. Be on the lookout.
Amen.
Be on the lookout. Preacher, what are you talking about? Well, I'm telling you, you better have a watchful eye. Why, preacher, do we need to have a watchful eye? Because your adversary, the devil, brother, he's walking about seeking whom he may devour. And amen, it's very, very important, brother, be watchful this morning. Be on the lookout. Be watching for him. I promise you this, brother, he's headed your way.
Amen.
Brother, he's headed to your house.
Amen.
Amen. And you know where the devil loves to catch us. Brother, he loves to catch us with a proud look about us. Huh? Brother, if you can ever catch it when you've got a proud look, brother, when you think you're above everything and everyone, brother, that's when the devil will attack. Brother, that's why the scripture said here to humble yourself, brother, in the sight of the Almighty God. Brother, I'm telling you, it's very, very important today for us, brother, as children of God, to keep ourselves humble. Keep ourselves where God can use us. Brother, keep ourselves where we can get a hold of God and where God can get a hold of us. Now, I don't know if you've been there or not, but I assure you this, brother, you can get in a state of mind. Brother, you can get in a condition yourself. Brother, you get so high and mighty. Brother, if you can't get a hold of God and God cannot get a hold of you, amen. Brother, I'm telling you, you can get to that point. It's very, very important today. Brother, keep ourselves humble and then where we have been, as God's children, brother, can get in touch with him and see if he can get in touch with us. Brother, I thought, brother, there's other ways, there's other things, there's other means today that get us in situations where we can't get a hold of God. Brother, there's a lot of things that come our way, brother, and get us down and out, and like I said, boy, go and get us discouraged. But I'm going to tell you, you get discouraged, I'll tell you what happened. If you keep going that way, brother, you just get deeper and deeper and deeper into it. And the first thing you know, brother, you can't get a hold of God, amen.
God bless you. That's true.
But we better be on the lookout. We better realize today who our enemy is. We better realize today who's attacking us. Amen. I'm telling you, folks, and if you remember here a few, it's been 7 weeks back, you remember what I told you? Brother, I told you, I don't know if you remember that, but I told you, brother, we were under attack. Huh?
Amen.
Now look around this morning over all empty benches. You think we're not under attack?
Amen.
Huh? Do you really think everything is loved in our life as we think it is? Do you really think everything going like it ought to be going in our life? Brother, we're under attack, amen. Brother, we're in a battle. Brother, we're in a war, brother. The hell take you Satan does today to make and run each and every one of our lives today. You know what happened? Brother, we ain't got a watchful eye.
Bless you, Lord.
Huh?
Bless you, Lord.
Do you really realize how slick the devil is?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
He's slickering all of us.
You know, we got a frame of mind that thinks every time Satan comes by, brother, there he is with a pitchfork. Huh?
Yeah.
You know what the Bible said over in the book of Luke? me just read it. I might misquote. Let me just read it. I'm sorry, to Matthew. 7th chapter of Matthew 15. For listen to this. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Huh?
Amen.
You hear what the scripture says? Be aware of those, I mean, that come to you in sheep's clothing. What are you talking about, preacher? I'm talking about you better watch your brother to come to you, brother, with a Bible stuck under that arm and that. Brother, everything that's rosy in your life and everything rosy in their life, brother, you better take notes of them. You better be very, very careful. Brother, they may be a devil and they may be a wolf, amen, and sheep's clothing. Get very, very careful. Brother, you'll fall victim, amen, to what they have to say, amen. Now, I'll be honest, I didn't want to preach this morning. I'd love to preach, oh, how I love Jesus and how Jesus loves me. But I'm telling you, church, we better be aware. Brother, we better open our eyes. I'm going to tell you something today, but everybody that says, well, the Lord is not going to intervene. Everybody that makes things above on their own is not God's man, amen. Your adversary. What are you talking about, preacher? I'm talking about your enemy. Huh? Going to and fro. Seeking. Who he made you by. Huh? What are you trying to do? I mean, rich, ruined. I'm talking about he loved to rip you apart. But you notice what the scripture says? It says, as a roaring lion. Brother, he is not a lion. Amen?
Amen.
Brother, he loves to disguise himself and make himself look like something else. Huh? Brother, that's the very reason today you and I need to be careful. Brother, we need to be careful who we listen to. Brother, we better be careful of what we listen to. I'm going to tell you something today, but I've got some more scripture I need to read. Brother, everything that comes along, I want you to know this. Brother, everything that's coming along, everything looks good, everything sounds good, brother, it ain't always of God, amen. Huh? Brother, there's a lot of wolves, amen, going around today in sheep's clothing. And I'm telling you what they're doing, brother. Deceiving people, amen, by the multitude. I'm talking about they fall today. Brother, they throw away to heaven, but you know what? Brother, they died and going to hell because they fed up with somebody that was dressed in sheep clothing, but it was their raven wolves, amen. Be able to look at it. Be watchful. Huh? Let me tell you this today. Because you're a child of God, it does not exempt you from one thing. Huh? Brother J. Birds today stand up and tell you because you're a child of God, you shouldn't have to go through this or you shouldn't have to go through that. But I'm going to tell you what the Bible said. The Bible said this, brother, that it rained on the just and the unjust alike. Amen. Amen. But you better be careful. These folks will tell you everything's all right. Because you're a child of God, everything's loving in your life. I'm going to tell you I have troubles, heartaches, and disappointment just like everybody else. Amen.
Amen.
I didn't know how this is going to go. I'm still going.
Good,
good.
Come on,
please. Listen to this. This is the 11th chapter of 2 Corinthians. 13th verse. For such are false prophets, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel. Now listen to this. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Oh, wait a minute, preacher. What do you say today? But I'm telling you this day, you better be careful who you listen to. Brother, you better be careful what you follow today. I'm telling you today, Brother Satan, he'll wreck you during your life if you're not very, very careful, amen. You mean, preacher, he'll transform himself? Yes, he will. Brother, he's out to devour you. He's out to wreck and ruin you, brother. He'll do whatever he has to do it today.
That's right.
Therefore, it is no great thing if his... Now listen, this is talking about Satan now. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. Huh? Brother, we better be careful. We better be careful. Huh? The Bible said, the thief cometh not, but to steal, kill, and destroy. I hope we got enough common sense about us, but we realize that Satan will use whatever he has to use. Huh? You hear what I'm saying? Brother, Satan will use whatever he has to use. Huh? You know what he wants to do? He wants to deceive each and every one of us. The thing cometh not but to steal, kill, and destroy. That's his mission. Huh? But Jesus said this, but I have come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. Now what do we have? What do we possess today? Huh? Do we really have a life that God wants us to have? Huh? What's an abundant life, preacher? You talking about a fine home, a new automobile, a new bass boat? That's worldly things. Huh? That's worldly things. You know what they're trying to do? They'll bring you misery. They'll bring you heartaches. They'll bring you disappointments. Huh? You know what a abundant life is? It's having victory in your soul. Huh?
Amen.
Having power with God.
Amen.
Huh?
Peace.
Yes. Do we really have a bond of life that the Lord has for us? It's okay, you just young lady. Just a young lady. Huh? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He's thinking this, these kind of terms. Well, that's for the most important. Huh? I'm going to tell you today, God, I want you to have a blunt life. He wants you to have victory in your life. Amen. He wants his spirit. His spirit. I mean, just to roll and roll and roll and roll over and over and over in your soul. That's what he wants. Huh?
Yeah.
But I'm talking about having victory in your life. Well, I'm talking about you, and I know you're young. I know you're young. But I'm going to tell you something. Brother God, God is going to live for us in your life. Amen. Ain't no doubt in my mind you feel right. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying this, brother, each and every one of us. Each and every one of us. Brother, you won't have to examine yourself very long. You can find out in your own life. Well, there's places you can move up to. There's places you can get with God that you never have been. Never have been. Church, we need to realize today, brother, we're in a warfare. We're in a battle. We're in a battle. Satan, Dawson. Son, he come to this office a few weeks back. I remember, son. You know what Satan loved to do? son, he'll go to breath, he'll right back out of the door. Let me tell you something, son, God has got an abundant life for you. He's got an abundant life for you. And there ain't but one way. Not but one way you can have it, son. But that's just put God first. Just put it first. Put it where it needs to be. Amen. Put it where the only place he's going to be. Bro, he's either going to be first or he's not going to be at all. A lot of people live good lives. A lot of people are good people. But you know why they don't have victory in their life? They do not put God where God belongs in their life. You can live a good life. You can be a good person, be a good individual. But I'm going to tell you here today, brother, if God's not number one in your life, I'm going to tell you here today, brother, he's not at all. He's not at all. He don't play second fiddle to nobody. Brother, he don't take a back seat to nobody today. Brother, he is God, and besides him, there is none other. But you know, we're not eager. We're not eager for the sake of devices. I realize most of the time that things are easier said than done. I realize that. You know this, every time we've got a need, every time we need something from God, I'm talking about every time, not just a few times, but every time we need something from God, you know what's going to happen? Brother Satan's going to throw everything he throws. He's going to put everything in your way that he put your way. Yes, he sure is. Remember old blind Bartimaeus over there? Brother, there he was, sitting by the wayside. Speaking. Here comes Jesus and the disciples and the whole multitude walking up outside. He found out who it was. You know what he did? Brother, he realized he had a need in his life. And he had a desire. Now listen. Brother, he had a desire to get a hold of the master. Brother, he began to cry out to God. Remember what I said a while ago? Every time you try to get close to God, you're going to have to face something. Brother, the devil's going to throw something in your way. Brother, hear that voice. The crowd said, told you to hush. Just be quiet. Leave the master alone, amen. But I got news for you today. Brother, this man had a need in his life. And brother, he knows the only hope that he had was right there next to him, amen. And they told you to keep your silence, amen. But the Bible said that he cried out the Lord, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me, amen. What are you saying, preacher? I'm saying this, you can overcome the thing that Satan throws in your way. Brother, you have a desire like he did in his heart. Brother, he had a need. He knew he had to get to Jesus, amen. Brother, every time I try to touch for God, Satan gets in my way, amen. But I keep pushing. Keep pushing. Keep praying. Keep seeking. Brother, I keep on and on and on. You know what happened? Brother, I'll eventually get there. Here he was, brother. He needed something from God. You know what happened? The Lord heard his cry. Sit for him. But he had obstacles. He had things he had to go through. Brother, we're the same way. The devil does not want us to get that God's got for us. You hear what I'm saying? Brother, there's multitudes and multitudes and multitudes today that need something from God. Some of us just need a closer walk. Some of us need more power. Some of us need healing. The needs go on and on and on and on. But you know, this is the good part. Brother, the solution is always the same. It's always him. Always him. Every time it's him. every time you make your way toward God, I promise you this. I promise you this. Satan is going to throw whatever he can in your way. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. But I've got good news for you. You know what we're supposed to be? This is according to the scripture. But we're supposed to be overcomers through Christ.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Huh? That's what we're supposed to be. But we ain't supposed to be just a bunch of old weeping Christians. But we're supposed to be overcomers through Christ. Huh? Now I'm going to tell you this, brother, there's things in this life, there's things in this world that you cannot overcome. I promise you, there's things you will face, you cannot overcome. Amen. But I'm telling you here today, through Christ, there's absolutely nothing, thank God, that we cannot overcome. Amen. Amen. Huh? Matter of fact, there's very, very little within ourselves we can do. But the Bible said this, through Christ, all things are possible. Huh? Now we see things that looks impossible. But through Christ, they're possible. Huh? Church, I hope you realize that. What kind of warfare are we in? What kind of battle we're in? Huh? Listen to this. Very familiar scripture. 6th chapter of Ephesians. 10th verse. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. And what? And in the power of his might. See, we can't. We can't just be strong in the Lord on our own. Huh? See, that's the reason today, buddy. You see so many people that's defeated. You know why we get defeated? Brother, because we do not follow the instructions. Huh? This is the instruction. Huh? And brother, there's people that instruct you in all kinds of ways. But brother, if what they instruct you don't line up with this, you better leave it alone. Huh? He said, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. You want to say it? Huh? Brother, we do not have ability within ourselves. Fight the fight. Don't have what we need within ourselves to go against the wiles of the devil. We can't do it. We can't do it. But I tell you this today, according to God's word, brother, through the power of his might, huh? Through the power of his might, brother, we can today. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Listen to these. Very important you hear this today. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Who do you battle with? What are you fighting against? What separates us? What's keeping us from being that God would have us to be? What's keeping us from doing that God would have us to do? What's doing it? What's doing it, church? You know what I believe has happened a lot of times? Brother Satan has slipped in nowhere. Huh? You know how he slipped in unaware? You know, do you realize that? How did he slip in unaware? Huh? Because
comfortable, boy, it's not watching. Be on the lookout. Be on the lookout. The devil, your adversary, your enemy. Brother, he's seeking whom he may devour. You know what the Lord told Peter over one time? He said, Simon, Simon, he said, Satan has desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. What's that saying, Richard? Brother, same way with you and me. Satan would rather have each and every one of us. Brother, he'd rather sift us. Get all, I'm talking about get every bit of the goodness out of us, every bit of God out of us. Brother, he'd rather sift you as wheat. Brother, that's exactly what Satan would rather do to each and every one of us today. But you know what the Lord told Peter? He said, but I have prayed for thee. When thou come up. I'll show you this today. Pray about the sin, kill, and destroy. Bethel Baptist Church, you will not be happy when you close the door.
Amen.
On Bethel Baptist Church.
Amen.
Huh? Richard, that'll never happen here. It'll never happen here. Give your car and go just a couple blocks. Huh? Just a couple blocks. You ain't got to go 3 or 4 miles, go a couple blocks. Right now, I'm talking about when you get out of church, drop out there. And what happened? You've done just exactly what is out there here. Huh? Sister George, if we're not on the lookout, we're not praying, we're not seeking God. I'm going to tell you what happened. Well, the exact same thing happened out here. We ought to look out. We ought to look out. You know, you'd love to shut the whole thing down. I mean, the whole, just shut it all down. But what? Something just hit you. Maybe it just hit you. Maybe it discouraged this stone here. Huh? If you can just do that. And especially pastor. Huh? See, I'm not exempt from this. I told y'all Wednesday night. I'm the most discouraged. It's been a long, long time. I'm not exempt from his devices. Huh? But I have no intent whatsoever. Let him destroy me. Well, I've got too much to gain to lose.
Amen.
Amen. Almost home. Almost home. You're right. You're on up in you. You're just almost home. I got news for you. You young ones. You may not realize it, but according to the scriptures, whether you're almost home today.
Amen.
You're almost home today. Huh? Soon and very soon. Soon and very soon. He's coming back. He's coming back. Church, like I said, encourage you anyway today. Be on the lookout. Watch for it. Look for it. I promise you, brother, any little crack he's squeezing, he's going to squeeze in. Huh? You know, it ain't always the big things. Not always the big things. It gives a lot of time, brother, just slipping in. Somewhere on to do something. The mistake we make, we'll leave it there. And it'll grow. And it'll grow. And it'll get bigger. And bigger and bigger. You know what eventually happens? We don't do something about it. Brother, we'll just get discouraged. We'll give up and quit. Be on the lookout.
Don't quit.
Be on the lookout. So I promise you this today. He's coming up your right way. He's going to knock on your door. I promise you that. He's coming. He's coming. I'm glad that we met someone today. I'm no match for him. I'll be honest with you. I'm no match for him. I've got someone living within me.
Amen.
Brother, they'll put him in his place.
Amen. Right here in the seat.
Greater is he that's within me than he that's in the world. Amen. I'm going to tell you, what do you see when you look at me this morning? I know I go back there in the mirror, I turn and go look. You don't see much. You don't see much at all. If you could see, what does it mean to me? What does it mean to me? Look, that's where my hope is. That's where my trust is in him, not me. Not me. How is it? How is it you today? How is it? Let me beg you about the church. Let me beg you. Don't ever let Satan see you thinking everything's all right and everything's all wrong. Come on, brother, that is the first song for this morning. I know it's been a little bit scattered today. I'm here to tell you today, folks. Satan is on rampage.
There you go. Get the song in his turn.
Don't think I'll whisper a little prayer. He'll go away when it bothers me again. Let me tell you something. Brother, he's going to gather to you as long as you're here. You hear what I'm saying? He's going to gather to you as long as you're here. But remember this. Greater is he that's within me than he that's in the world. If I was here this morning, when I was about to babble, I was discouraged about that night. When I was about ready to throw the towel in with you.
I am. I'm throwing the towel
in. What I do, give me some victory in my life. I will. Dave's son, I know you've been discouraged and put him down now. So I know I hope we got it. You know I hope we got it. I'll tell you, son, it's going to be a better road than we need. I promise you, Dave.
Come on, we can get done. I'm ready to go.
Even to the end of the world. You can't make a deal like that. You just can't make it. You can't make it. Never promised him wouldn't have trouble. All that's miserable. But he did promise this, that he'd go with us all the way. All the way. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Keep your eyes on the prize. And soon, very soon, we're going to see the king. Go ahead, son, brother. You hear me? You know what you're doing, huh? You know how things are in your life.
It don't do me no good. I ain't good enough.
Turn together around prayer with him this morning. Been fighting the battle for a long, long time. Don't care how many times Satan's told me, just throw in the towel and quit, just give up. But I'm gonna tell you what I've told you time and time again.
Oh,
precious Lord, lead. bless you. Yes. You know, sometimes we just need encouragement. And you know, there've been a lot of times in my life I've tried encouraging people. Been a lot of times. Some of them probably might have helped, some of them not. Let me tell you this. Brother, there is encouragement in the Lord Jesus Christ. Huh? Sometimes I can't help nobody. But there's never been a time that he couldn't help you. Never been a time that he couldn't encourage you. But I'm going to tell you here today. Brother, there's so many things God has for us. So many places that God loves to take us. But we've got satisfied and we've got content right where we are. I'm telling you this today. Brother, he's gone on a prayer for his horse. And he is coming again. He's coming again. Soon and very soon. Brother, is there anything in my way? If it's just a little bit of doubt, I'll tell you what I'd do. I'd get it out. I'd get it all fixed up. Get it all fixed up. Do you ever stop and think about this? You ever stop and think about how many's in hell right now? Huh? We need to stop and think about that. But there's people in hell right now. While we're here in Bethel Baptist Church, and people, Brother Josh, that's in hell right now, screaming, squalling, begging to get out. More likely, most of them, still just like we're standing right here today, had the opportunity we have. A lot of them are probably some little bitty something in their life. Just some little bitty something. But you know what they thought? They thought within themselves, I can handle this. I can fix this. They said something. You could handle it. If you could fix it yourself, Brother Lord wouldn't have had to come from heaven. He wouldn't have had to die on the cross. You can't handle it. You can't fix it. Brother, it'll take his blood. It'll take his blood. I was here this morning. If I had a need, I take what I do. I just come to one and fix it. I don't have the ability. I can't keep my own self straight. Brother, I'm not like everybody else, but I have to find my altar. I might be an altar. I have to find the altar. I have to find quite often. Preacher, you make me mess up. I sure do. You know, good and well, the pastor can mess you up. Everybody else probably does too. I hope you're way above I am and don't want, but I'm telling you, more likely you might be. Huh? Matter of fact, I'm going to knock out the head.